In 2020, this delimitation commission was constituted to carry out exercise on the basis of census 2011. Delimitation is a complex exercise, but an electoral democracy must perform it periodically to fulfill the requirement of territorial representation. And our constitution envisages that. Jammu and Kashmir has a long history of delimitation. In 1951, the then state was having 100 seats as delimited by the delimitation committee. 25 of these seats were for POJK. However, first full-fledged delimitation commission was formed in 1981, which could submit its recommendations after 14 years in 1995. And it was based on 1981 census. Thereafter, no census had taken place. No delimitation was taken place. In 2020, this delimitation commission was constituted to carry out exercise on the basis of census 2011 as per section 62 of the Jammu and Kashmir Act 2019. The Delimitation Act 2002 provides the manner of this process. Honorable Supreme Court in its judgment held that delimitation is not a mere mathematical exercise we can't do on the tabletop. It must reflect the political aspiration of a society bound by geography and different topography. As per section 14.4 of the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act 2019, it is very clear that 24 seats in the Legislative Assembly of Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir shall remain vacant and shall not be taken into account for reckoning the total membership of the Assembly, and the said area and the seats shall be excluded in delimiting the territorial constituencies as provided under Part 5 of this Act. Section 60.1 of the Jammu and Kashmir Act 2019 also specifies the number of seats to be reserved for the scheduled caste and the scheduled tribes in the Legislative Assembly having regard to the relevant provisions of the Constitution. This is the first time under this Act that the seats will have to be provided to the scheduled tribes also.